Inside every person, there is a battle raging between two wolves. One is evil, which is jealous, angry, unforgiving, and it is lazy at the same time, it is proud. On the other hand, you can see that there is one which is filled with love, happiness and peace, humility, with that self-control. The fight is going on. Which wolf will win? That is the question. The answer to that is simple. Whichever be the one which you feel. Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and guests.
Good evening.
If you feed the angry, jealous, unforgiveness, lazy and proud and other negative traits, they will become stronger and stronger. For instance, if you say, my boss is treating me bad and my company is not treating me well, my girlfriend is angry with me. Ironically, when we say this one, these negative thoughts, it makes us happy. But you have to remember that the wolf inside you is getting stronger. That means you are feeding the negative thoughts. At the same time, look at the other end. If you feed happiness, if you feed peace, loving, and if you go for humility, self-control, you can see that the positive thoughts, are coming in and the character traits are developing in you. For instance, if you don't want to get up in the morning and go for a job, that comes as a negative, but you can always make it as positive. You can say that, God, at least I have a job. We can do it in the morning. Habits are acquired learned behavior, which we use us in our day-to-day life without noticing it. And many of the habits, as you know, which we are getting it from the home or maybe from the places which we learned it during the time. If you are in a home where the people are harsh, or people doesn't care about the time, or they don't want to, the neatness is not there, or those kind of stiff things are there, then you will definitely pick it up. The other place, you can see that if there is happiness, the places where the people are there, the positive energy is there, everything will be neat, everything will be clean, and everything will be in order. Definitely you will pick up that also. So it's up to the person to decide what you want. You want to go to the negative side, you want to go to the positive side. Definitely you may have the negative thoughts, you may have negative habits, which the good thing is that you can convert. Recently the studies are showing that the 90% of your daily behavior is based on your habit. That means from the morning when you wake up till in the night you go for sleep, everything is based on your habit you have. How you treat people, how you speak to your boss, what you listen, what you hear, everything is based on your habits. That means this 90% of time you are on an autopilot. It's keep on going. The good news is that, you have to change it. If you want to change it, you need to know where you are going to change. What is, you have to take a stock taking of yours. You have to take an inventory of yours. Do you have any negative thoughts coming to you every time? Are you complaining every time? Are you late to your office? Are you every time having some issues with your boss? Are you talking negative about your boss, about your friends? Once you say it is there, then yes, there is a chance to, once you understand your problem, then there is a chance for a developing a positive attitude, positive habit. Recently, the study is showing that it needs 6 weeks for a person to break a habit. Some of the studies showing that 21 days you can break a habit. The fact is that Dr. Maxwell Maltz conducted a study in 1960. He found that most of the people whom he tested, the samples, 100% converted their behavioral habit. So there's a good news for everybody. If we want to change ourselves, and if you want the negative to go to a positive, you can have it. You can go through, if you are willing to take the pain of change, you can try for it. Brunei is a place where, you know, the golf is very famous. The golf is one of the accepted games here. When you look at the international golfers, you can see that most of the golfers go for their trainings almost every day. Some people go for 500 hits a day. Some of them go for 1,000 hits a day when they are not in a competition. This is basically to make sure that they get the they are repeating the right swing. So when this helps them when they are in a competition, automatically when they are under the pressure, the swing automatically comes and they can do the right swing there. That is the advantage of the making it as a habit. Before I conclude, whether your habit is good or not, it is going to affect your, to some extent, it is going to affect your future. If you have it is easy to have a bad habit, acquire a bad habit, but difficult to live with that. At the same time, it is difficult to have a good habit. If you have a good habit, it can give you a very good fruit at the end. Thank you. With that, back to you, Toastmaster.
Thank you very much, Alex. We will definitely nurture our good habits. At least I'm trying to do it very hard, for 20 days or whatever, 6 weeks. And then I have a bad day and everything is gone. My bad habits are coming back again. So I wish it would be as easy as you said it is. Next.